Hey, what's going on, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. And in today's video, I have a very classic comparison video between two 35 millimeter lenses, one $70 lens from Seven Artisans, and one $3,400 lens from Leica. And the results are seriously going to shock you. Wow, that was some YouTube clickbait shit. Alright, so I'm sure that most of you guys are familiar with this kind of format video, so I'm going to throw up 10 images right now, and you guys comment down below in order whether you think it's the 35 Summicron or the 7 Artisans. 10 images, comment down below in the order which lens you think took the photo. And go! So, what did you think? All those images looked pretty nice, right? Sharpness, colors are there. I will be revealing the order of which these lenses are taken by whichever lens in a few moments. I'm going to quickly talk about the build quality of each lens, and both of them are very outstanding in the way that they were made. Although I bought this 7 Artisans lens for $70, it definitely does not feel like one. It is a full metal body lens. The focus throw is pretty nice and solid. It is dampened enough where it's not too loosey-goosey and not too tight to speed focus when I need to. The metal lens hood that came with my edition, I'm pretty sure this isn't a 7 Artisans circular lens hood, but it's great for what it is. It doesn't block the viewfinder. And of course, with the Leica 35 Summicron, it's a well-built lens, also all metal. Focus is actually stiffer than the 7 Artisans. I have to like wiggle it once for it to start loosening up. I don't know if that's just an issue with my copy. Aperture is nice and clicky as well. It's nice and in line with the lens, so it's like really hard to bump it on accident. And I don't know if this matters a whole lot to anybody, but the Summicron Spherical version 2 comes with a metal square lens hood, so that's pretty cool. The version 1 Spherical comes with a plastic one, so that's a little thought for you. If I'm gonna be completely honest, both of these lenses are really similar in terms of its like feel and construction, but the 7 Artisans aperture ring is much heavier and clickier, and in my opinion that's better because, like, you know, for function wise, like, it's gonna be really hard to accidentally bump it versus this one where it's like it's a lot looser, but it's clicky, it's nice, it's like not a complaint at all. But for the 7 Artisans, man, that just feels very nice. So I actually prefer this aperture ring over this one. Yeah. So that's just a quick comparison of these two lenses when it comes to like the looks and the function. The 7 Artisans, albeit 1/50th of the price of the Summicron, does not feel that way at all. But when it comes to the image quality, is it 1/50th of the Summicron? So if we're going to talk about the 10 images that I posted earlier in this video, only the first and the 10th image were taken by this 35mm Summicron by Leica. The second all the way to the 9th were taken by the 7 Artisans. Now, if you go back to that part of the video, you could probably say like, dang, like those photos do look pretty good. If you really look at some of them, the vignetting is pretty harsh on the 7 Artisans photos, and those were mostly taken all on Kodak film, scanned by the same lab, developed by the same lab, but they were nearly shot at 5.6, and usually at 5.6, a lot of lens flaws disappear as they would on like any digital lens. When it comes to this Leica Summicron lens, you are truly getting the best out of the best in terms of sharpness, color rendition, corner to corner sharpness, vignetting, and also the bokeh. For the 7 Artisans lens, you're also getting really great performance for a $70 piece of equipment. And at f5.6 for both of these lenses, it's almost impossible to detect which lens is being used to take that photograph. But the proof is in the pudding, and the proof is shown when you shoot both of these lenses wide open at f2. At f2, the Summicron is perfect. You won't get any problems with it at all. But at f2 for the 7 Artisans, man, does it start to fall apart in the corners. It falls apart on the edges. It even loses a lot of contrast and sharpness. It looks like there's haze in the lens, but at 5.6, it disappears. So at f2, I have no idea what's going on. When you open this lens wide open, all of the softness comes pouring in like a flood. The contrast disappears. The colors start to look a little fadey. The bokeh looks really rough, actually. It has like a nice character to it, depending on what your taste is. I kind of like it, but it's definitely nowhere as smooth as the Summicron 35 when it's wide open. But a lot of details get lost with the 7 Artisans lens, because at f2.0, you can even tell that like my white t-shirt in sunlight starts to glow. I didn't mess with the clarity. The lens was not smudged up. I made sure that it was all clean on the rear element and the front element. It's just kind of weird how that happens. Although it's not that weird, because it is a $70 lens at the end of the day. So why did I even get this lens to begin with? Well, it was actually my first lens that I got for my Voigtlander Bessa R2A. That was my first M-mount lens, and it stuck with me all this time because 35mm is my primary focal length for any work that I do, and obviously it's not that easy to pocket a fat Joe Schmo like this. This lens has treated me so well over the year that I've used it, and I had no complaints with it because I primarily shoot at f4 and above in broad daylight. So my final opinion on this $70 lens versus this $3,400 lens is, well, I highly recommend the 7 Artisans lens for any everyday photographer who doesn't shoot at any aperture bigger than f4. So if you're shooting at f2.8 or f2, you might not want to use this lens. You could buy a Zeiss 35mm f2. You could look into other Voigtlander lenses in the 35mm range, like the Nocton or the Color Scope R. But if you're shooting at f5.6 and above, like if you're using Portra 160 or Portra 400 in broad daylight at 1/1000th of a shutter speed at f5.6, this is getting very technical, I know. This 7 Artisans lens is going to treat you so freaking well. The images that I've got off this lens were perfectly fine, and it really is a nice build quality lens. It's fully metal. The aperture is so nice and heavy. It's awesome. But I got this Leica 35mm Summicron because this camera is going to be in my life for the rest of my life and hopefully be passed down to my children. So a lens that could stand the test of time in all scenarios without performance dropping off, it is worth the pay. Is worth the buck that I've paid for it. And like, honestly, like, it's such a beautiful lens. The colors off of it are so magnificent. I was so impressed that a lens can actually change the look of film that dramatically. And for film, it comes down to the film stock and the lens. The body does nothing for it, but I guess it also comes down to your scanner as well. So make sure that whoever is scanning it, whether it's a lab or the method that you use at home, make sure that it's top notch so that you can keep that quality that's being produced by lens like this. 7 Artisans though is seriously no joke. It's 1/50th of the price of this lens, but it holds up super dang well. And that's all I have for you guys in this video. Thank you guys for watching. Subscribe for more film photography content. Like this video and comment down below, and I will see you all in that next video. Peace!